Sydney, Australia. I have traveled from Hollywood, California, the capital of narcotics, with my beautiful band, the Mechanical Animals. And I ask you one thing. I want you to sing this song for me, you motherfuckers. Next motherfucker gonna get my medal. Next motherfucker gonna get my medal.
Now I wanna grow up!
It's the most beautiful.
Wanna be!
fucking motherfuckers.
Here comes the kid.
Confessions will be televised.
the drugs, the drugs, the drugs. I know you guys are more exciting than the Gold Coast. But I want to know, how many rock and roll niggas tonight? Cause I am the All-American.
Yeah. You might as well kill yourself. You're already dead.
Let me ask you one last question. How does it feel to be one of the beautiful people?
We'll be right back.
with a beat. The rule of a kill. When you want to appear, I bash myself to sleep. One year so I will reap. I scar myself to see. I wish I wasn't me. I am a little stick. Stabby, stick. I hate the fall I am. Goddamn, you're right to say. Goddamn. 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 Zero. I'll be forever.
Part is basically from Marilyn Monroe,
mm-hmm.
and Manson comes from Charles Manson.
Right.
Yeah. So, Well, Charles Manson might fit the image more, but I mean, where the Marilyn.
Well, I think there's very much Marilyn and Manson. I think Marilyn Monroe was very Hollywood, show business, glamorous element, which I think comes across in part of what I do. And I think Charles Manson was the more sinister and nihilistic element, but also a very rock and roll element, because I've always seen Charles Manson associated for me with music, particularly the Beatles, Helter Skelter, and things like that.
So can you tell us like how the band first met and how it all got together?
Well, the reason I put it together was I had a lot of things that I wanted to say, really more like philosophy almost. So I considered being a writer for some time, but I discovered music would be more powerful. But Marilyn Monroe and Charles Manson, I thought, was a combination that described my personality, positive and negative, and male and female, and beauty and ugliness. So 6 years ago is when I put the band together to, a canvas, really, to kind of paint my picture.
How did you meet the other members?
Right now, the only original member besides myself is our keyboardist. Mm-hmm. And he and I met, and neither one of us had ever done anything musically before.
But we both,
but we both loved, you know, a lot of the same bands, David Bowie and Alice Cooper and Black Sabbath and things like that. So we just decided to just do it and learn as we go, and then we've grown, you know, over the past 6 years.
So you've been doing some covers like that, like what, which I just said, Sweet Dreams and Rock and Roll Mania. So how did you come to the idea to do those songs?
When we were doing Smells Like Children, I wanted to do some of the songs that were both my favorite songs lyrically, but also songs that I thought were important to culture. You know, I thought Sweet Dreams was one of the best songs ever written about relationships.
Yeah, that had a real strong message in it.
And I thought Rock and Roll Nigger was a song that I could really relate to, and our fans could relate to, about being an outsider. Uh-huh. And I also thought that nobody else really in our era of music had the courage to do a cover of a song like that, because you know, they would get in trouble for the title. But the song isn't about you know, racism. It's about standing up for yourself.
Yeah.
I think it's always been part of my nature growing up to question the popular opinion of the mainstream. And Antichrist Superstar really is an album about just that. I mean, it translates beyond just being against Christianity. I mean, here, I think in Japan, people could relate to it on terms of, you know, questioning the popular opinion. But it's an album about searching for something to believe in, and going through religion to relationships to drugs to power to music, and finding in the end that you can only believe in yourself. I've always tried my mother's makeup when I was growing up and things like that.
I did that too.
I think it's part of just redefining the definitions of male and female, redefining beauty and ugliness, because a lot of people would normally use makeup to, you know, make themselves more beautiful. And then people think my makeup makes me look scary or ugly or whatever they might think, but I think I just try and redefine beauty. So.